he's the comedian who puts a whole lot of energy into his work, and anyone or anything is fair game.
It's the 2021 closing down sale. Everything 2021 must go. Hurry, we're getting rid of the Greek alphabet. Alpha, Delta, Omicron. You can all go and get stuff. Uh-oh, we're overstocked on billionaires. All our billionaires simply must go. It's a fucking space, apparently. Get them quick before they destroy small business on another planet. 3, 2, 1.
Mark Humphries is the next guest in the hilarious new show, Would I Lie to You? But can he tell if fellow comedian Dave Thornton is telling the truth?
Whenever I used to host a barbecue, a backyard barbecue, I'd entertain friends with my Dance of the Tongs.
I love this.
I think Dave knows what the first question is. Please perform the Dance of the Tongs.
Like, someone said to me, they go, do you play an instrument? And I said, yeah, yeah, the air tongs. I was like, I started doing all this. And then I just started going like this.
Yes.
And then in the big crescendo, when the guy was strumming away, I'd just go...
Did that 3 minutes.
I want to know, have you ever performed the Dance of the Tongs since?
Thank you for asking, Mark. No.
OK.
Mark Humphries joins us now on the couch. It's so nice to see you. It's been too long.
It has. There used to be more applause. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, no, it's been 3 years, and I got to say, Kerri-Anne and Joe, you look fantastic. Whatever you're doing, keep it up. Amazing.
So nice to see you. I think the real lie, though, can I just say, from Dave Thornton, is that he really is Dave Hughes. That's yeah, the lie, right?
His impression is incredible. The number of times I've shown that to people, oh, man, go look that up. Dave Thornton, Dave Hughes impression. Yeah, you won't be disappointed.
It's crazy. What made you want to do this show?
Contractual obligation. Look, I think the British version is fantastic, and also the fact that Chris Taylor and Frank Woodley are the team captains. I mean, they're just brilliant. They brilliantly cast. Chrissy's lovely, and they've stacked it with incredible talent. So, you know, you're guaranteed to have a good time.
It's fantastic. We're huge fans of the show, and it's a bit like The Office. When The Office started in the UK and went to the States. But I love the fact that we have our own version here. What can we expect to see on tonight's show?
Depending on how it's edited, I might have said something that will come back to haunt me. But other than that...
Blame the edit.
I'm going to be watching like this. But the stories tonight are hilarious, and I actually can't remember what was true and what was false because everyone was so convincing.
And that is the best part of the show. Hey, you've got a couple of little boys, little ones. Do you lie to them? Do they lie to you?
Yeah, it was just a series of big... one big mound of lies that we tell the boys. The big one, really, at the moment, is that our television is broken. So, yes, because they were watching too much, so... And I can say that because they will never see this because they think the TV's broken. So that's a big one. And then, at the moment, I read somewhere an idea about when you go to the toy shop and the kids want toys, the best thing to do is to say, OK, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a photo of the toy and send it to Santa.
Of course.
And so my phone is just toy photos. That's all it is now. I don't know what they're expecting. I mean, I don't think they understand that Christmas is still a long way away, but that wish list is too long.
Now, you've got your comedy show coming up. It's called Spin.
Wow. Yes.
Talk about it. Spin right now.
So I'm teaming up with satirical heavyweights Charles Firth, who founded The Chaser.
Oh, yay!
And, awesome.
Who went previously on the show, I think Kerri-Anne gave out his phone number to everyone. Yeah. He still gets calls from Studio 10 viewers. That is true.
He still gets messages.
And James Schlaffel, who created The Shovel, satirical website The Shovel. And we're doing a sort of masterclass in the art of spin in the lead up to the election. We're going to be teaching people how to make a delicious curry to distract from their latest policy disaster, and how to avoid answering questions by pretending that you've already answered them.
Beautiful. Right, we're going to play a game, if you're into it. Two truths and a lie. Here's what we got, OK?
So we're going to tell you two truths
and one lie.
OK.
Right, so I did not start driving until I had kids. That's one.
OK.
Yeah? One of us is wearing a piece of your clothing. Yeah? And lastly, I was in the original lineup of Boyzone before Ronan Keaton.
Gosh, these are all fantastic. Well, I do recognise those shoes, so I know which one's the truth there. I mean, this jacket, this ensemble looks familiar.
Yep.
But, yeah.
Tristan in the back gives it away.
That's what I'm wondering about. Yeah. Does it say... Is there
Should
a faded mark in the back?
Says Grant Denyer.
When I started here, I was wearing Grant's clothes. But anyway, and now the driving thing, yeah. I still can't drive. So that's absolutely...
You can't drive?
I still can't drive.
Really?
No, well, that was actually on the first date with the girl, I told her that I could drive, and I couldn't.
That's a lie you're not on.
Yeah, and 15 years later, I think she started to catch on.
How did that come to be, that she found out?
Here we go.
Just 15 years of me saying, I'll get the next one.
You had an Uber?
Yeah. Driver's seat, I always think, is more comfortable. You can have it. I'm sorry, dude. Sorry, I've got to play this game. I want to believe it's Boyzone. I really want to believe it's Boyzone. I'm going to say, so, which one of them is the truth? Is that right? Or one of them is a lie?
Two truths and a lie.
Okay, I think the Boyzone must be the lie, surely. That's two. Oh, God.
No, you're right. It was a lie. That was not close. In the original. There was a rumour a long time that it was Colin Farrell was actually in the original Boyzone.
Oh, right. Yeah. He was in a group called Soul's Edge.
Which were better than Boyzone. All right. So maybe, I thought maybe a Boyzone tribute band, like Boyzone Again, like that's the one again.
Yeah, Manzone. Yeah. It turns out that this is your shirt.
It is my
originally,
shirt.
Yeah. What's the backstory
for that,
though?
What are you doing with it after the show, can I ask? Because it looks fantastic.
I think it's gone back on the hanger, I believe, for another 3 years.
TV is rough.
For the next show. You can catch Mark on What I Lie to You tonight at 9:20 on 10 and 10 Play On Demand. Hey, Mark, before I let you go as well, I've just got to say, our beautiful friend, John O'Coleman, who had so many beautiful things to say about you when he was with us. And I just wanted to let you know that because he just thought you were such a star. And every time he saw you, he'd, like, chase you around the studio. So, yeah.
Thank you, Sarah. He did a sketch with us from 7:30 and he was brilliant. I love John O.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Thank you for that.